I'm Kevin, and this is Randy.
I am.
And we're here today to talk about when your computer won't start, when you can't get into Windows. And, you maybe you have no lights turning on, you can't hear anything, maybe there's an error message. Yeah, it really sucks. So we're here to hopefully help you find where the problem is on your computer and how to fix it.
We will. We will do what we can.
All right, so Randy, how would we get this computer started? It won't start right now. What do we do?
Well, first things first, you need to kind of understand how a computer boots up.
Okay.
Right? So first it needs power. Right? It gets the power from the power outlet, brings it into the power supply. Then it has to set up all of its insides, basically. The hard drive, the keyboard, the video. That's called BIOS or POST. Once it gets past that, then it can load the operating system, usually from the hard drive, which we usually know as Windows. Okay, so that's all the stages that it kind of has to go through before you can actually use the computer.
Okay.
So it helps to know.
Okay. So what you're saying is it first has to pull power in, comes in the power, then the power goes mm-hmm. to all of the different components or devices in here, and it recognizes it. And then it can, after it knows everything and has power, it can load the software, which then takes you to Windows.
Then you can use it.
You can use it. Okay.
Okay, but anywhere along that chain of events, if any of those things fail, depending on where it fails, that kind of helps you troubleshoot that problem.
Okay, so based on where it fails, that kind of points out, here's your problem, if it's dying in that chain somewhere.
Yes.
Okay, gotcha. All right, so how do we get this thing running?
Well, before you get this thing running, right, before you start, you want to make sure that anything that isn't absolutely necessary is not plugged into it. Okay, you want to just have the keyboard, the mouse, and the monitor plugged in.
Okay.
Things that you don't want plugged in, especially are like printers and USB storage devices.
Ooh. You mean like this one?
Yes, because the computer will try to boot to that, and it might get confused.
All right.
Well, what would you do to start it up?
Obviously, I'll just do what anyone does. I'm going to push the power button.
Okay, now listen. What do you hear?
I heard the power button come on.
Right, but you didn't hear any fans, right?
So true. I didn't hear anything else like that.
That tells us that there's, probably not getting any power, plus there's no light on the front. So let's look at our cables, power cables.
So the power coming in, as we
talked
about.
Okay, so there's your power supply, right? That's the thing that charges it up. So what you want to do now is you want to check your cords.
Okay.
Right, because maybe you moved it and it doesn't start, so check to see that the dog wasn't chewing on it. Or it didn't. Maybe it just became unplugged. You want to try a different power outlet. Maybe the problem's with the power at the power outlet. You never know.
Yeah, and these are pretty easy cables to swap out to try a new one. They're pretty standard on most desktop computers.
Yeah, you can try another cable. That's a very good troubleshooting technique. So go ahead and plug it in there and see if we have power after we've tried those things. No. Okay, now we have a light that's come on. That tells us that there's now power to the power supply.
Power outlet to cable to the computer is all good so far.
Yeah, so the power supply is charged. Now it can charge the system when you press the power button.
All right, so we want to try turning it on again?
Yeah, before we do that, though, that Touch Smart over there, that's a little bit different, right? Touch Smart's an all-in-ones. Sometimes they have a power adapter, but same basic principle. Some of them don't have the lights on there, so you don't have the luxury of looking at that light. But same basic philosophy. Check your cable. Sometimes you have to replace a cable or the power adapter itself.
Which is a little harder, I guess. This one here, that's a good thing about desktops is their plugs are pretty standard, but with these, you won't be able to swap out a plug as easy.
Okay, so let's go ahead and flip it around, press the power button, and then listen again to see what you hear.
Okay.
Listen for fan noises or beeps.
Whoa.
Ah.
That's probably not good.
Yeah, beeping noises in general are not good. That's telling you that the computer, during that, now we're moving from power to that POST or BIOS area where the computer's trying to set up the components.
Right, so the internal parts are trying to get where it's recognized by the computer, right?
Right, and now it's saying it can't do that. It's having a problem with one of those devices. One of the most common is memory. Right, memory is a common failure. Processors, your processor might be bad, or it may be clogged with like dust, and it overheated. Things like that. So, but one good trick that you can do when you get beeping noises is to swap the memory or remove the memory module and reseat it. I know it sounds like it's...
So pulling the computer open and actually pulling out the memory chip and then pushing it back in to make sure it's secure and in there.
Right, that's a trick that we'll get a lot of them, not all of them.
Right, so if you do that and it's still beeping at you, it's possible that the memory's bad.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm tired of this beeping, so what do we do?
Well, let's we have to do something about the beep.
Okay. Okay, it's off now.
All right, so disconnect the power cord, okay. And we'll take the side panel off.
Don't want to electrocute anything in there, having it on.
All right. Okay, so right here, let's get a better look here. Okay, so to reinsert the DIMM, the memory DIMM, you undo this clip, bottom one, and then there's one on the top that you push on, and then that kind of pops the DIMM out. And to reinsert it, you push on the bottom until it clicks, and then you push on the top.
And you can hear it click when it's in place right there, right? That's locked in.
That's right. And now when you're in here messing around, you want to handle the DIMM on the edges only. You don't want to touch the surface. You want to be careful of the other sensitive components in here because you can damage them. You want to try to work over an area that doesn't have carpet. And then also while you're in here, you can check some of these other things like the hard drive connectors and some of these other connectors just to make sure that they didn't come out because they also might be the cause of why it's not booting or why there's a beeping noise.
So you just want to make sure we're careful while we're in there not to cause damage to anything else just connecting.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so let's put the panel back on. And so when you're inside and you're receiving that memory, you want to make sure to keep your hands away from other parts around the motherboard. Okay. Also, if you have a TouchSmart or an all-in-one type of a computer, a lot of those you can replace the memory. Some you can, some you can't. But if you can, there's usually like a little cover that you have to remove. So you can perform that step on a lot of those.
Yeah, and HP's website, you can go out and put in the model number, mm-hmm. and you'll find information documentation that shows you how to take apart your PC and put in the different parts.
Yeah, HP has a lot of helpful support articles on part replacement. Okay, so now let's plug the power back in.
Okay.
And
see what happens.
That's right. Another moment of truth.
Beeping sounds be gone. Here we go. Hey, blue light, that's already progress. I hear fans and no beeping. I hear things starting up.
That's good.
Okay.
But what's not good is you don't have any video.
Yeah, still not going over to the monitor, so the monitor's still blank.
So now we went through the power cycle. Now we're into this whole BIOS post thing, right?
Right.
So now you're going to have to troubleshoot a blank screen. Right?
So you have power coming in. It started up. Sounds like the PC's running all fine. Now it's the connection between here and here that we're worried about.
Something it might
going
be the connection
here.
Between here and here. That's what we're going to troubleshoot now is the blank screen. So just like you troubleshoot the power on the computer, now we're going to need to troubleshoot the power for the monitor.
Okay.
Right. Now this doesn't really apply to a TouchSmart because it has a built-in display. If the TouchSmart has power, but the monitor's blank, there's really not much you can do except for maybe service it.
Okay.
Okay.
Call it.
But for this, what would you do here first?
Well, I'd probably turn on the power here. There we go.
Look at there. Now you have power to the monitor. What does it do?
Oh.
Check video cable.
So it's telling us that there's something with the cable or connection not working.
Yep. So black screens are actually fairly common, you know, when it comes to boot issues, like if your monitor goes out. But, you know, so you still need to do the same thing like you did with the PC. You have to check the power.
And it's kind of telling
you
to do that. So
now you got the video cable, so now you check your video cable. So you have two connections, one on the back of your computer, one on the back of the monitor.
Okay.
So why don't you check that one? I'll check, make sure that this is all plugged in. Okay, my connections.
Reconnect it just to make sure it's there. Okay.
Okay, any change?
Still nothing.
Okay. So at this point, what's really useful in troubleshooting a no, kind of a blank screen scenario, is to swap the monitor. So this is really useful. A lot of people don't have an extra monitor lying around, but if you have a friend or something that has one.
I have one. Old, reliable. I keep this thing around all the time because it never fails. It's probably like the first monitor I ever had.
All right. Well, why don't you go get that one? I will disconnect this one.
Okay.
And then we'll hook that one up to the computer, and that will help tell us whether or not it's with the problem is with the monitor, this one,
okay,
or if it's with the computer, like the video system in the computer.
Okay, so the video itself, the video component or part of this might not be working too.
Yes.
And this will let us know if it's the monitor or that. Okay, I'll grab the monitor.
I will get this one out of the way.
All right.
Right.
So we got Old Reliable set up here. And this is going to tell us for sure you can always count on Old Reliable.
It does.
So we'll know if the monitor is the problem. Give it a shot. Should we start it up and see?
Yep. Turn that one on. Turn the computer on. And let's see
what
happens.
Blue light. Blue light. Fans coming on. Mm-hmm. I hear the things starting up. We have video.
Ah, did you see that?
I did.
Initial startup screen came up.
Oh, wait a minute.
Yeah. Now it looks like we have an error.
There's an error there.
Okay, so this is another no start scenario, right?
Yeah, it says no boot disk has been detected.
Right, but before we get into that, what does this tell you now that you have video on this one?
Well, we know from the different three steps that you talked about, power's coming in, we mm-hmm. have power in here, the components are there, it sent a video signal. So now we have over here that the monitor is working. So that means the last time with our other monitor, there was a problem with that
right.
other monitor.
Right. It tells you this is now able to send video. So the other monitor was not
broken.
Good. Something was going
Something
on
was
with
wrong
that
with
other
it.
Monitor. Okay. But now Old Reliable's got an error message on here.
Right.
Okay. So with an error message, what you can do, right, is you can take that exact error message. In this case, you have error, no boot disk has been detected or the disk has failed. Okay, you can take that error, you can use that exact text on the internet or HP's website to look for more information.
All right, okay. So just write it down exactly and search on that.
Okay, I want to talk just a little bit about errors. There's kind of three different categories, right? There's errors involving hard drives. There's error in certain conditions that indicate like the file structure has been damaged. And then there's also just lockups. Right, where it hangs during the boot cycle when it's loading Windows.
It's stuck on a screen and never goes anywhere else or something.
Correct. So in this case, no boot disk. It has the word disk in it. Okay. There's bio HD errors. There's this one, no boot disk. There's OS not found. All of those can indicate that the hard drive is missing or not detected.
Non-system disk, I've heard of that one as well.
Yeah, non-system disk. All of those things that have disk in it or HD is saying that when this thing's going through this BIOS sequence, this post, and it's trying to configure the devices, it can't configure the hard drive. And that's kind of different troubleshooting because it's not going to be able to load the operating system because it can't even detect the disk or there's some problem there.
So the key here, though, the error is kind of giving us an indication of where the problem might be occurring. So it's telling us here it's something mm-hmm. with the hard drive. So
and
we
you
would
need to
probably
use
go to the hard drive and check and make sure the cables there,
yes.
again, are set, that maybe the power's all in and things like that.
Yeah, make sure, of course, you can check the cables on the hard drive, kind of like what we did earlier with the memory. There was the hard drive there. You can check the cables, unplug them back in. But if it's not
electricity built up or something, maybe that's causing something.
Yeah, you might get lucky. Oftentimes, you know, like especially like with a smart drive error, a smart hard
you
drive.
See smart drive is what it says on the error.
If you see smart on there, that's telling you that your hard drive is failing, right? So if you can back up your data as soon as possible, but you're going to probably replace the hard drive.
Okay.
The next set of errors are those that involve any sort of like file. Like if it says something.dll or something.sys is missing or corrupt, or you see everything's black except you just see a little blinking cursor in the upper left,
right.
And it doesn't. All you see is that blinking cursor. That's telling you that the file structure, something on there is bad, and you might be able to, you know, to boot in, press F8 to come to a menu, a Microsoft menu. If you're lucky to have that come up, then you can do like a Microsoft System Restore to kind of go back. If that doesn't work, you know, then you can do a full-on HP recovery, like a system recovery,
okay.
Which you might end up losing a lot of your data and stuff, but you at least get to save your computer.
So
it's
it
not
makes the software work again. So what you're saying is in this kind of scenario, it's possibly the hardware, maybe software. But if you have something messaging like the type of file or a file of some kind that's indicating a software issue.
Yeah.
And if you have that, you can try to restore it if you can get to that point.
Yes. A hard drive error, you're probably going to have to replace the hard drive or there's more serious thing. If there's a file error, then you know, you're likely going to be able to recover that using an HP recovery. Like in the event of some nasty viruses, for example, that go in there and destroy system files, an HP system recovery will get you back and running again.
And I've even heard of like the startup repair thing coming up. People say that mine mm-hmm. says startup repair, continuing or checking or something.
If you're lucky enough to have that happen, it might just automatically recover from itself.
So it'll run through, just let it run, mm-hmm. and then it comes up. And I've actually seen it at home as well, and then it'll run a system restore on its own, if it can.
Yeah, just let it run. Whenever it comes up and prompts you to do something, do it. Press the space bar or whatever, and then hopefully Windows will load. And if that doesn't happen, then you might have to do a Microsoft system restore or an HP recovery.
If you have recovery disks, if your hard drive doesn't work, you could use disks and start from there.
Okay, so let's talk about the third one, which is the one that's not the most fun, and that's that's the lockups. So if your PC is starting up and it's going through and configuring, and it might even get to the point where it's loading Windows, it'll say, you know, Windows 7 or whatever on the screen, but then it locks up
and never gets into Windows.
Right. It may lock up on the HP logo screen, it may lock up at a black screen, it may lock up, you know, out on the Windows. If it kind of locks up anywhere in that cycle, you might have heat related problems.
So that's why you hear the fans a lot of times with that. The fans will kick on really loud when that kind of thing happens.
Yeah, oftentimes the fans are having to work harder to try to remove the heat, and inside it just kind of locks up and it can't get anywhere. So unfortunately, you know, about the only thing you can do is use canned air, like this one. And you can blow around the vents, like around the power supply. You can remove the case, the side panel there, and blow around wherever you see cooling fins and fans to get all that dust that's accumulated out of there.
Right.
And here, like on a Touch Smart, it's a little bit different.
So it'd be like across the top where you see the fans there.
Yep, your vents.
And down across the bottom, because the air comes in and tries to flow through and push the heat and all that. So you want to clear out the intake and the outtake of the air flow.
And that might get you back up and running. Hopefully it gets you back up and running enough so that you can run some HP hardware diagnostic tests. There's HP Support Assistant that comes with your computer. You can run those tests to try to figure out, you know, what component's failing.
Right.
But it can be difficult. And luckily, there's some helpful articles on our website.
Right. So if you go to hp.com, the same as with any of these errors that we talked about. Again, if you're seeing an error, if you've got it to your PC, you know you've taken care of all the hardware like we talked about earlier, and you get an image on your screen that starts to tell you that you either have a component failure or you have a software failure. In either case, go to hp.com/support and search on these errors, whatever that condition is. Mm-hmm. Take as much detail as you can about what's happening, and you're likely to find a document that's going to answer your question, tell you how to fix it, or at least if you can't fix it, it'll help you know which part failed. Like maybe you got a bad hard drive and you need to swap, put in a new hard drive, and then you're back to running, you know, really well. But if you don't find it on HP site, try, you know, your favorite search engine. You're likely to find something in a forum or somewhere else. But most errors and error conditions, someone has dealt with and fixed or can help point it out. So that's the main point.
Yeah.
So that kind of covers it all. We've went through talking about the power coming into the PC, what it takes to boot up and start up to get into Windows. It has to get all of your components working, send the video signal over, and then load the software files. And a problem can occur anywhere in there. So hopefully we've shown you how you can test to find out where the error that you're having occurs, and then you can find the solution based on what that is by either searching hp.com or trying some of what we talked about already.
Yep, you should be well armed to at least get it down, isolate it down to where the problem is occurring.
Thanks. Talk to you next time.